Welcome. This is Accounting with Bennett Tchaikovsky. Our topic today is property, plant, and equipment, specifically double declining balance depreciation. This educational fundcast is copyright 2008 to 2018 by Bennett Tchaikovsky, all rights reserved. Okay, so we're still Sahar's Mom Class Call Inc., which is an awesome, amazing company. They purchased equipment, and this is kind of similar to our other, it's the same hypothetical, except now we are using an accelerated depreciation method. The reason why this is an accelerated method is because we are not taking any type of salvage value into consideration. We're taking the acquisition cost less the accumulated depreciation, or the total amount of prior depreciation taken to date, divided by the estimated useful life, multiplying it by 2 to get that full year depreciation, the double declining balance. And why do we use this type of method? Well, there are certain assets where you essentially have more use out of them in the earlier years, and they cost more to maintain in the later years. I'm not going to mention any cars by name because I still want my endorsements, but let's go ahead and start up. So let's go ahead for my first year. So this is asking us to compute double declining balance for December 31st, 2019 and 2020. However, when we're doing later years, because the way we're computing it is a function of the amount of the accumulated depreciation that we're taking, we need to compute 2018 as well. So for 2018, my acquisition cost is $500,000. And I've put the equation up there in case you need to go back and refer to it, but I would refer you to the other videos for a lengthier discussion. For 2018, I have taken no depreciation as of yet. So that amount is basically, it's my first year, no accumulated depreciation. I'm dividing this by 5, which is my estimated useful life. So I've got here 500,000 divided by 5. And what this here is going to be giving me, I'm going to then multiply this by 2 because it is double declining balance. What this will be giving me is 500,000 divided by 5 times 2, or 200,000. Now, what is 200,000? This is for a full year double declining balance. However, since I bought this equipment on April 1st, I need to multiply this by the period of use during 2018, or 9/12. So what I'm going to do here, is I'm going to take 200,000 times 9/12, or this is basically April 1st. Through 12, 31, 18, and I'm going to get a total of 150,000. So if I go to this chart, and this chart's gonna be very, very important because we saw from our other examples, we cannot depreciate beyond salvage value. And if you look at this equation, unlike units of production or straight line, any type of salvage value is not considered. So we need to be really careful. So my acquisition cost is not going to change. It's 500,000. The amount of the depreciation expense that I take during this first year is going to be 150,000. So my total accumulated depreciation to date, since it's the first year, it's just this 150. My net book value, which is really here, my acquisition cost minus the accumulated depreciation, is going to be 350,000. Now my salvage value is 200,000. So as of right now, technically I'm okay, mainly because I have not yet gone below salvage value. So I can continue to depreciate the asset. Let's see what 2019 looks like. So 500,000 acquisition cost minus 150,000, because that is the amount of my accumulated depreciation or the amount I've taken to date. I divide this by 5, which is my estimated useful life. So here I'm gonna have 350,000. And I'm gonna multiply this by 2, dividing by 5, and I'm gonna get 140,000. So this is 2019 depreciation under double declining balance. So in 2019, my acquisition cost doesn't change. The amount of the depreciation expense I'm taking is 140,000. So my total amount of my accumulated depreciation as of December 31st, 2019 is going to be 150,000 plus 140 or 290, giving me a net book value of 210. Now, my salvage value is still 200,000, right? I cannot depreciate beyond salvage value. So can I continue to depreciate this asset? Well, the answer is gonna be kind of like barely, right? I can only take 10,000 more. So what I could do right now is more than likely, if I were to compute the depreciation expense, I'm almost positive it's gonna be greater than 10,000. So I could just basically put 10,000 here, force the depreciation, or I shouldn't say force, but I should say push the depreciation to that amount. Whoa, okay. But we'll go ahead and we will compute the depreciation for 2020. So if I compute the depreciation for 2020, I have a 500,000 acquisition cost minus the 290,000 accumulated depreciation. I'm dividing this by 5, and I'm going to get 210,000 divided by 5 times 2, or $84,000. And so if I take 84,000 and I put this in here, my accumulated depreciation is going to be 290 plus 84, 374. My net book value is the 500 minus 374,000, and I have a problem. Why do I have a problem? My net book value has fallen below my salvage value. What does that tell me? It basically tells me that right here, I cannot take this amount of depreciation. So I basically need to force the depreciation for 2020. So what I'm going to do, and when I try to figure out the amount to force, if I'm over in this year, what I'm going to do is I'll call this AA minus BB equals CC, DD, CC minus DD. And here, if I go back to the year before that I had this amount, I see that comparing net book value to salvage value, I get my amount of forced depreciation. So my depreciation expense will be 10,000. What I'm then going to do is take the 290 plus the 10, and then now my new net book value is going to be is going to be 200,000 And so now when I compare this, I have a $200,000 netbook value. My salvage value is $200,000 and I'm done. How much depreciation expense would I take in 2021? The answer is zero. This asset is now fully depreciated and I can no longer take any more depreciation. So it's very important to go through and to basically, this is the hardest part, which is basically if you're being asked to go through and to over depreciate an asset, you have to make sure that in that particular year, you basically, you force the depreciation so you do not go below the salvage value. So that is double declining balance depreciation. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you on the next video. Thank you so much.